Lala is back, and here he is taking on, I don't know if that's a kickboxer. Ooh, qilala throwing some more flashy kung fu stuff. Oh, almost doing a sweep. Interesting. He's almost moving like a capoeirista. Dude, I love this. No, oh, he ate that hook, though. Dude, it's always a joy to see qilala try out new stuff, right? The hands down stuff, I don't think we're a fan of. Yeah, I feel like he's getting inspired by capoeira. What do you guys think? Anyways, qilala trying to fight in the clinch. Ooh, ate a cross right there. So, yeah. So this is another guy he's sparring against. That spinning back fist landed. Look at that, him trying to trap. So, he's really testing his reflexes. But see, the thing is, he always eats something. That's a Taekwondo kick he's doing. The Taekwondo uncle did that kick where it's almost like clinch range. He does an inside kick on you. So, not a fan of this hands down. Not a fan of this at all. But hey, trying to sweep, that was good. That fighter has like really, really pink shin guards. Look at that. Must be his girlfriend's. I don't know. Anyways, okay. Not a fan of this part, but hey, what do I know? That was a good thigh kick. So, oh, again, dude. Imagine if qilala keeps incorporating that. It's like in the clinch range, you throw a kick that could potentially knock them out. Oh, outside crescent kick by the pink shin guards guy. Wow. I'm just going to call this kung fu play. Oh, he shoved his head against the wall. Man, that wasn't cool. So, okay, that's some chi sao. The guy with glasses, I believe, is Jerry. That's qilala's coach, Jerry, I believe. I think I could be wrong. Don't pak sao me if I got this person wrong. I believe that's qilala's shifu. So, dude, qilala's connecting with him too. Why are they both wearing glasses? Dude, what is this? I get it. You know, if you get attacked, you can't tell the attacker, yo, just hold on a second. I got to take off my glasses. Right? There's actually a really funny self-defense technique. I can't show it because last time I tried to show it, they didn't respect fair use and they tried to take my video down. But it's like a guy, he's like, hold up. Let me take off my glasses. And then he uses his glasses and he throws it at the other guy's eye. It's really funny. He's like, if we're going to fight, I'm going to take off my glasses. If any of you know what I'm talking about, leave a comment. Anyways, you know my hesitation / reservations about chi sao, right? You might be able to apply this in a ground near waza situation. So in Brazilian jiu-jitsu, this is actually very helpful. But when people can just throw a hook your way, I think this actually builds bad habits because it teaches you to keep your hands away from your face. That's just my opinion. Again, I'm sure Wing Chun people can write me essays about this. This is the one thing about Wing Chun that I'm not saying this is ineffective. It's just people don't understand the point of this. Like, if you train this for Brazilian jiu-jitsu or judo, this can help you immensely. But training this for striking, I think, very limited applications. Even qilala, who does make it work, he ends up with so many punches to the face. Here we have a Hung Gar, Hung Gar competition. So this particular branch of Hung Gar, Hung Gar is Liu Gar, aka Lau Gar. So lots of spin kicks and side kicks. So, wow, this match is crazy. It almost looks like continuous Taekwondo sparring. But of course, the mechanism is different. In fact, if you just saw earlier, the yellow shirt threw a calf kick. So look at that. So the punches look a little wild, but the kicking looks like Taekwondo. So, oh, he got him. Wow. So, shout out Steven, by the way. Steven Skelly, our viewer who we featured before. Oh, that's an axe kick. Was the one that showed me this. This is one of the schools he trained under. They used to host these competitions. So, yes, it's a little bit like a bar brawl, but then if you really break it down, really look closely, like you see axe kicks, you see a lot more skill than the average bar fight. So, here we go. So, it's funny that they're completely bladed. And it does make you a smaller target, right? But then when they start swinging punches, they get shouldered or squared off. There's a little guillotine right there. So it sort of was walking off. I don't know what happened there. Ooh, I think I saw an elbow. Are they wearing gloves, guys? Yes, they're wearing gloves. So I'll link you guys this channel. This is, I believe, the official channel of the school or the lineage of Hung Gar that viewer Steven trained in. So, yeah, we saw an example. Oh, he did a jump. I don't know if it was a jump hook or a jump palm technique, but from my region of China, we would call it 空中铲儿式. 空中铲儿式, which is like, I jump and I smack your earwax out. That's what I call that move. So, sidekick again. Another axe kick. It's really cool. I never thought you could land an axe kick from like a very bladed position, but I guess I learned something today. He was trying to sweep and it did not work at all. It's almost like he didn't follow through with that sweep. So, that jab landed. We need a little bit more angles in both of them, man. They're just going in and out, which is not necessarily bad. If you take that paradigm that a lot of these martial arts evolved in the days of weapons, then, yeah, if you're sparring with weapons, then it makes sense why the point sparring paradigm would work. It's like one hit with the weapon, probably someone's dead. Anyways, guys, let's go on to the next one.
We have a Streetbeefs MMA match. That is Division right there. Throwing the sidekick. He's the Kung Fu guy that we've shown before. And Samoan Beast is the guy he's going up against. So I don't know what style Samoan Beast does, but Division is a Kung Fu guy. Ooh, look at that, throwing a back fist. So, ooh, both stomping at each other's legs, man. Very smart, very smart. I think if you stomp at a Muay Thai guy's, ooh, little cool combo by Division. If you're stomping at a guy's legs from a striking standpoint and you can't go to the ground, it might be a little dangerous. You might really anger them. But, you know, if this is MMA, then if he blitzes in, you can just take him down or negate his striking in another way. Looks like Kung Fu guy is pinned against the cage. He's got his hand pinned against the cage, too. Oh, there we go. He's transitioning. Going for a straight ankle lock. Ooh. Oh, okay. Ooh. What is he doing wrong? Let's think about this. Does he have enough leverage? The way he was cranking, I don't think was the right leverage. Anyways, he tried some up kicks. Good. Good defense on the ground. Samoan Beast also not trying too hard to pass, mostly waiting for an opportunity like that. So, that's the advantage when you're standing above him, right? You can decide if you want to engage. Oh, got reversed. He sort of trying to go for rubber guard, now trying to go for arm bar. Ooh, slammed a little bit. He can't get the omoplata from here. Nope. I think he unfortunately needs to let go. Yeah, he needs to look for other sweeps or other submissions. He had that arm trap, but that was the end of the first round. Good show of respect here. Wow. Finally throwing a jab, throwing a leg kick, followed up by a jab. You could almost call that like a swivel jab, right? So it's like a leg kick to a swivel jab. That's pretty cool. Ooh, that was great. He did eat the kick, but he also timed a kick counter. Oh, that hook kick got him. Woo! Look, starting with the back fist again. Ooh, jump, spin kick. Wow. Dude, I love it. People are showing off their kung fu flair. There you go. That was a great, great combo. Oh, good. He connected. Ooh, he got him. Ooh, he got him. Oof, wow. He got him with a knee. Ow. Woo, let's watch the final moment here. So that was a great combo. And then Samoan Beast kind of presses forward, right? Counter attacks. And see, he got a... That was actually a kung fu technique right there. It wasn't a hook. And then right there into a clinched knee. Got him. You see that?